Then for the foils, you're going to want to basically take lift off the foils, which means move the head of the foils forward. The main foil, sort of rough terms, if you weigh 175 pounds, if you weigh more, you're going to wait longer to take lift off the foils. When the lulls are 12 knots, I move from the third pin to the second pin. When the lulls are 18 knots, I move from the second pin to the first pin, which is all the way forward. And I say lulls because from a race tuning's perspective, you're always trying to set your boat up to foil all the time. And you basically just deal with it when it's, you know, trying to jump out of the water in a 20 knot puff, even when you're set up for it to not blow more than 15 or 16. That being said, if it truly is blowing, like we had one day where the top gust was like 22 and you could barely foil at points during the race, it was like 6 to 22. Remember that easterly day in Newport? It was super duper puffy. From a racing perspective, the correct move was to set your boat up as if it was blowing 6 to 10 knots. It made your boat basically impossible to sail in the puffs. But you got, basically, you could get so far ahead and then just like capsize in a puff that it kind of worked. But if you're out recreationally sailing, you can totally just be like, okay, I'm not going to foil until a puff of at least 14 knots comes through.
Yeah, I'm only going to surf the waves.
And so if you're set up to only, you know, in 14 knot plus puffs, put yourself in the second pinhole. You can even put yourself in the first pinhole because you can launch in the first pinhole in 12 knots if you have to. But it's kind of like trying to launch at 8 knots. You know, you're basically making the boat super marginal. So one of the things, particularly when it's puffy, is you can detune the boat and make it tougher for yourself to foil, but also way more relaxed and comfortable once you're up on the foils. And that's just sort of a choice you can make. You can make the boat in 12 knots of breeze feel like it's blowing 8 just by detuning the foils and detuning the rig. We went through the main foil, you're sort of going one pin forward at a time from the third pin to the first pin. If you're a bigger guy, I know James Blake likes the fourth pin, and I think for marginal conditions, I will in 8 to 10 sail in the fourth pinhole back. The problem is that I can usually get launched in those conditions in the third pinhole, and I can carry the third pinhole comfortably up to about 16 knots. The fourth pinhole, I can't really carry above 12 knots. So, I did the fourth pinhole in the Forks Battery race because I was having trouble getting the boat to foil, and it got so bad, and I kept ventilating and capsizing at the end of the race, I stopped, changed my main foil settings in the middle of the race, and then finished because it was just like, this is the only way I'm going to get across the finish line. This was a really poor tuning decision I made before the race started. And honestly, if I'd stopped 2 minutes into the race, I would have done so much better. I just, you know, was like, no, I'm going to hold on to it. I'm going to hold on to it. This race is, you know, 5 miles on foils. It only takes 15 to 20 minutes. Like, just hang on till the end. But the breeze came up pretty quickly, and there was no hanging on to that fourth pinhole. Following with the rudder. So when you're moving your main foil forward one pinhole, expect to take at least one full turn off the rudder, maybe two full turns. And to some degree, when I'm resetting the boat, I move the pinhole forward, I sort of guess it to what I want to take off the rudder. I sail, I see if I'm bow up or bow down, and then I adjust my rudder to get the boat level. Bow up, you know. If I bow up, I add rudder lift, which is turning the wheel to starboard. If I bow down, I reduce rudder lift, which is turning the wheel to port, and I get the boat so it'll foil level again. The other trick here is where your rudder lift, you will move around a lot more than your main foil lift so that you can stay in a certain pinhole. So if I'm in third pinhole and the breeze starts to increase, what will happen is the boat will start to just lift up and go bow up and just launch out of the water. And what you can do to hold on to third pinhole is, you know, up, you know, all the way up to about 16 knots is where I think it's sort of comfortable to hold on to that for someone my weight. You want to be adding rudder lift to keep knocking the bow back down. And what you end up happening is you have the foils sort of working against each other to some degree. The main foil sort of lifting the bow up and the rudder foils pushing it back down and keeping you pitch stable. And you end up in a point where, like, the rudder's pushing your bow down, the mainfoil's pushing your bow up, and to some degree a certain amount of their lift is sort of counteracting each other, and that's how you hold on to basically a certain mainfoil AOA setting higher up the breeze range as you keep adding on rudder lift. Now, you will get to a point where you add on rudder lift and the boat sort of gets nose down but just keeps rising and the whole thing comes out of the water. Or you ventilate your rudder, which you will know when you ventilate your rudder because the boat will spin out and chuck you. Versus like mainfoil ventilation, the boat just sort of goes nose down really quickly. Like the bubble gets sucked down to the mainfoil, you lose all lift and you sort of nosedive. Rudder ventilation is quite a lot more violent and the boat will spin out a lot of the time. Like the stern will just go downwind and you'll get chucked. So when you start getting to that where you're nose down but the boat still is like getting high enough to flick the wand forward, that's a sign that you should have moved forward a pinhole on your mainfoil.
Essentially overloaded the system, so it's got so much angle attack on and there's so much speed that it can get out of wind speed that it's generating velocities which are lifting it beyond the controls. Controls can't stop it from going higher and higher and higher, so that's the part we need to decrease the angle attack across the system.
Yeah. So that's if basically if your bow's coming up but your stern's staying low, you can add sort of rudder angle to get the boat level. If you just are all the way out, wand flicked forward, and the whole boat is just like trying to fly straight up out of the water, that's a sign, reduce mainfoil lift, reduce rudder lift, and just overall have less angle of attack across both foils. And then you can start playing your rudder again as the breeze moves up and down in this new sort of regime range.